Today, we will try to understand the second wave of COVID-19 and how it is impacting the people. With the beginning of 2021, India slowly started reporting COVID-19 cases. There is a new wave of infections arriving, and this time with more panic, more disaster and more fear. As the pandemic comes back, there is a shortage of everything: oxygen, drugs, vaccines, ventilator beds and even cremation centers. Let's quickly discuss the second wave of COVID-19 in more detail and understand why it is more harmful. The bigger question right now is the Indian healthcare system heading for collapse? According to the Health Ministry data released in October last year, there was an availability of only one doctor for every 11,082 people. Yes, it was a matter of concern in the last year, and it is a matter of concern this year as well. And this time, it is much more severe. Hospitals are overflowing with patients. Oxygen supplies are dwindling. Ventilator beds cannot be found, and yes, many innocent people are losing their lives every single day. Dr. Tedros Adhanom, the WHO's Director General, also said, "The situation in India is beyond heartbreaking. It is becoming very clear that India has failed to prepare itself for the second wave." Now, let's come to another part of suffering, which is the need for vaccines and antiviral drugs. Your doctor may prescribe you to take an antiviral if you come in close contact with your family members or others who have the flu. However, the CDC discourages this as a routine practice, as it can lead to drug-resistant strains of the virus. The antiviral drug Remdesivir, which was widely discussed during the first wave of coronavirus in India, is back in talks again. But the question is, does it actually work? If we talk about its history first, Remdesivir was designed by the American pharmaceutical company Gilead Sciences. It was made to treat hepatitis B, but it never got approved for marketing. COVID-19 brought this drug back into the picture. Some studies suggest that taking the dose of Remdesivir shortens the length of a patient's stay in the hospital, but unfortunately, it does not reduce the mortality. So we really need to think and ask, when do we really need this drug? Because it has mixed results. Some found that COVID patients who received the drug recovered faster, however few people died. Based on the WHO study, Remdesivir had little or no effect on hospitalized patients, as indicated by overall mortality, initiation of ventilation and duration of hospital stay. Now let's come to another cure. Nowadays, everywhere we hear that people are asking for plasma donations. So what is it and how it can be helpful in preventing the deadly virus? As the need for a COVID vaccine grows, most medical practitioners have recommended an old method for fighting with COVID-19. This treatment is called plasma therapy. It is a medical process where blood is donated by recovered patients to establish antibodies that fight the infection. Let's first discuss, does plasma therapy cure COVID? Currently, it has shown positive results in Delhi and Mumbai, where COVID cases are spiking high. It has also proven to improve the ability of a person to recover from the disease. However, there is more research required to prove its full efficacy in different patient types. For now, the only practical solution seems to be an effective COVID-19 vaccine. In order to effectively distribute the vaccine, the National Expert Group on Vaccine Administration for COVID-19 was constituted to discuss conceptualization and implementation mechanisms, including setting up of a digital platform for the management of inventory and delivery of vaccines. Please get yourself vaccinated, because that's the only solution. If you are able to book your slots, please do it right away without any delay. Safety is a top priority, and you can really find enough reasons to get yourself vaccinated. The COVID-19 pandemic has changed all of our lives in a multitude of ways. And after months of being stuck inside, limiting exposure to friends and family and juggling responsibilities at home and at work, it's no surprise that many of us are still dealing with frustration, anger and more. I recommend you to become a more resilient person who has the desire and motivation to do the best each day. Instead of being crushed by the weight of it all, approach life with a sense of hope. In the end, I would just like to say that take good care of yourself and your family, because in the end, life matters. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care.